Hello! No, God, no, oh God. Sorry, everyone, we don't know what's happened to Budgens and Dragons, everything's on fire.
I like how when you introduced that, it kind of had the best break screeching in the background, it kind of sounded like the intro to Budgens and Dragons again.
Yeah!
That was intentional. It was not. Welcome back to Budgens and Dragons. We are on loop. I didn't get this ready. 89 today.
It's happening, fucking, yeah.
Ooh.
A lot has happened. 89.
A slightly more complicated sex number.
Yeah. sex with an octopus, I guess. we are joined, as you can hear, by some of our regulars and a very special, not Emma, who the fuck's Emma? A very special new guest.
And, it's Emma on the name.
Yeah, but it's wrong. I wrote Emma, it's just, it made me sad. we are joined by some new people. One is our very first American player, and the other one is from the live shows at Boredom Bites every month, first Thursday in Cheltenham.
I don't know why I'm waving. I don't know why I wave. Sorry, guys.
It's an audio podcast, Rob, yeah. So you fucked that up.
So we're editing it in, it's fine.
Yeah, it's keeping it in. So we'll just go down the list, go through what we're plugging and who we're playing as. We'll start off first, doing this really well, with Alex.
Hi, I'm Alex. I edit the show and I do Twitch, and I think my first character is going to be random.
Oh, random character, okay.
Yeah, well, I think I'm going to start now with a random character.
57? Oh, God. So, Alex's character firstly is Garfield. You love lasagna and your bear Pookie. You hate Odie and Mondays. Pros are, to play it, have you had lasagna this past week, Alex?
I have not.
Okay, so you're going to have a bad day. It's not a Monday, so that's fine. You've always got an advantage over people called John. How was your Monday last week, Alex?
It was a Monday after I got back from Bristol, so it was pretty good, I guess, yeah.
Okay, so it would not be a bad Monday for you. Excellent stuff. Ollie.
Yes. Hi, I'm Ollie. I'm from the Sitcom Podcast, and I
bring it back! Let me tell you something, mother! Woke Hogan's running wild! Making sure that everyone is being politically correct and everyone's getting on and having a good time. But, however, every now and again, a old tweet may resurface of how I used to behave.
Lovely. What's your pro?
I'm so happy this session is bringing him back.
Yeah.
Pro is he's got pythons for days. And he's Hulk Hogan, Woke Hogan, sorry, so a completely different person. So he has a lot of star power. Cons are that occasionally his very dubious past can come back to haunt him.
Lovely stuff. Thank you so much. Emmy.
I'm Emmy. I'm also part of the Sitcam podcast, which you should all go and listen to, and mm-hmm. also have a very important cat Instagram at our.pumpkin.patch on Instagram, just said that. I'm bringing back Sweet Potato, is a three-year-old orange tabby cat that mother found as a kitten and gave him a home because he was so cute. Sweet Potato gets his name because he was found outside the grocery store. Maybe it was Budgens. Outside Budgens. In a basket of sweet potatoes. He's a classic orange boy. He only has access to the brain cell occasionally, so he's a bit stupid. He does speak human. He's very chatty, especially when he's hungry, and he just wants to make mother happy, so getting the scratch pad is very important to him. His perk is that he's got very good hearing with his cat ears, and his flaw is lack of brain cell most of the time. He's also got his favourite toy mouse, loves fish flavoured food, and chin scratches.
Love stuff.
Peter Potato is one of my favourite characters.
I love him.
By popular demand, as we've been doing, the genuinely popular demand has been ridiculous.
Beating down the door as we speak. Sweet potato.
Whoa, guys.
Joe, who are you playing as?
Hello, I am.
And also, what you're doing?
What am I doing? I don't know what I'm fucking doing. I am known as Joe Del Toro on Twitter. You can follow me there if you want. I'm the host of the Greenlit podcast, which is where I play a producer. I give random prompts to people. Eddie, you've been a guest before as well. And essentially, it could be video game, TV show, movie. You have to use what prompts I give you to give me a pitch. And I basically judge you based on that. So far, we've had a slasher film where Superman wrecks the world for fun. And also, he's played by Matt Berry. We've also had a VR game where you can go to a royal wedding with a knife and, quoting the pitch, do what you like. And that was it.
That's what we've got. Good time.
I am mainly known for hamburger on Budgens, and I am going to go as some hamburger multiverse variants. However, there's going to be a little bit of a theme because I'm going to give you basically the shit ones that I didn't think were very good. I'm just going to go for the rejects. Basically, within the multiverse of hamburger, the hamburger verse, if you will, these guys are known as kind of like just the lowest rung.
So with the hamburger variants, they're not, the pros and cons aren't revealed until they're revealed in the episode, just to keep them a nice surprise.
And so, in case they get killed off and I don't waste them.
Yeah, like it happened with Punish Hamburger, RIP.
Yeah, may he rest in peace, yeah.
Yeah.
Rest in punish.
Okay, good. just throw me. Mike.
That's me.
How are you, Mike?
I am great.
Good. Very nice to have you here. Have you got anything to plug?
I will be plugging my book, How to Adult, which is a book that I've written about basically helping people fill in the gaps of knowledge of what you didn't learn when you were in high school, what you should have learned, and general information on how to be an adult.
Very helpful stuff.
Yeah, how to shave.
Lord, I need that.
Thank you, Mike. And who are you playing?
My character's name is Mr. Stevenson. And Mr. Stevenson is a completely naked short man who wears only sneakers, thick glasses, and a bowler hat. He's a lawyer who can bring a suitcase out of somewhere in plights. His positive trait is his nudity is always comically obscured by random objects or conveniently placed things. His negative trait is he is a lawyer.
Lawyer, great. I just think of like a Looney Tunes Saul Goodman in my head. Which is definitely what I need in my life. Thank you, Mike. And Rob.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm fantastic. It's an honor and a privilege to be here. Very excited to take on the game. I'm a I guess you could say comedian of sorts, writer, Choutman. I run Lemon Rocket Comedy. If you don't know what that is, check it out, look it up, come to Choutman. Come and see our first gig, 1st of September. We're relaunching. I'm the captain, and it's going to be a good fun time.
And who was running up before Rob?
Hey, that would be Eddie O'Keefe, the wonderful, talented Eddie O'Keefe. So taking over the controls of that, and I'm very very happy to be doing so as well. So
Rob, who are you playing as?
I'm going to start off I think sensible warm up, and I'll go as a random character as a warm up.
Okay, thank you, Rob.
I appreciate that. That is not the sensible choice, I'm afraid.
No. 78.
There's a lot more now, isn't there? There's a lot more.
Still 100. Still 100. We're not making any more just yet, but maybe we are. You are David Twattenborough.
Ah, yes. Okay.
So you're a man who loves to be a dick to nature, and you document it. Your pro is you know how to approach any animal. Your con is you torment the animals, followed by a BBC crew everywhere you go.
Oh, that's brilliant. That's really fitting. I like that. Actually. That's kind of my thing.
There's also two cats in this episode too, which is great.
Yeah.
Potentially a dog as well.
Yes.
I shall have to go.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, this is going to be a fucking
I'll
nightmare.
Defend you in court.
Yeah. Good luck. We have the
lovely stuff. So, first things first. Head to tails.
Tails.
I heard heads first, it was tails, unfortunately, so no do-over for you. Ha, ha, ha. No do-over. Weather check and mother's mood. So, for fuck's sake. Okay, so mother's very happy, but it is, unfortunately, a sunny 20, so the house...
Oh,
mate.
house does burn down and everyone does die.
Cue the music.
Great leap, everyone.
Well, you were worried that we were going to win it straight away, so there you go, we didn't.
There's no do-over, no, sorry. Yeah, everyone's dead, fuck it. Okay, I've got to just make a note. Sunny,
real 20. Dream team.
I guess God wins.
I don't think I'd feel comfortable if that didn't happen on the first round anyway. I think it was fun.
Yes. So is everyone playing the same character?
Yes.
Nope. You said no. You said no.
I said no. I'm changing to the character that you have. I said you.
Poor Garfield. Fuck off. It wasn't my
That's gonna be my new thing. So whenever there's a do over a 20, whatever it's totally, I'm gonna just not be the character that it'd be.
It's obviously fate.
The fuck policy.
Yeah.
Yes.
The rule of fuck. Basically. Yeah. great. Alex is doing fucking a rule of fuck. Who are you playing next?
The character that sent you in the DM.
Oh, of course. Like, you can, so Alex sent me a character in my DMs. I am not allowed to say who this character is yet. Because shut the fuck up, mate.
Why is a motorbike?
I know. What's the same fucking one? Simply because the character just hasn't turned up yet. So they are coming at a later point. But they will be aware of the task at hand just to avoid any confusion.
Yes.
Heads or tails?
Tails.
It's heads, you can do it all.
Editor's note, this won't be confusing later, or will it? We'll have to see.
Stuff.
I'm not doing that anymore.
Okay, so it is a windy 17 today. So very, very windy, very dangerous. Lots of people are staying aside because of the wind, it's very strong. A mother is feeling in love.
Oh,
nice. So, it's a windy day in Farringdon. Mother's in the kitchen making a cup of tea. We'll cut, first of all, to sweet potato.
Sweet potato is curled up on the bottom stair. And he wakes up and he stretches out along the stair. And he thinks, this is a good spot to lie. I'm just going to stay here for a bit.
You do not have the brain cell today.
He continues to think, this is a good spot to lie. I'll stay here for a bit.
Lovely stuff. We then cut to Woke-a-mania.
Woke-a-mania is going through his wardrobe, trying to decide what to wear. Puts on the yellow shirt, but then promptly sort of rips it open anyway, so it's bare chested. Doesn't really matter. Puts on his red headscarf and is about to go down the stairs, sees that Sweet Potato is there, so he does the only sensible thing that Woke-a-mania can do and... not going for Sweet Potato, but going for the bottom of the stairs just does a big old leg drop, so you get down there quicker.
Can you firstly roll a perception on a d20, please?
Mm-hmm. Four! Number 11. Four!
I've got 11, so your perception's a bit off. Can Sweet Potato and yourself roll an d20, please?
Seven.
Number nine.
Okay, so you do unfortunately leg drop on Sweet Potato, which could potentially break his poor little neck.
Was that an unfair 20 then?
Unfair, yeah.
Okay, so can Sweet Potato use his excellent cat hearing to hear like the wind of the leg, like the leg drop creates?
And then
if he's heard it, quickly shoots out the way.
Roll a 20, please.
Okay. Hogan's not known for his stealth.
17.
No. 16, you're very lucky.
Yes.
So,
Hogan's like, Hogan leg drops the bottom of the step. Can you roll over 20, please, Hogan?
16!
I all got 15. Ooh. So you hurt yourself very badly, but you're not dead. You just fucking break
I'll just
hip.
Get another iron rod in my back, brother!
So you've broken your hip. So Hogan has a broken hip today. So that's good. We then cut to... Mr. Stevenson.
Mr. Stevenson wakes up and pops out of bed, stretches, and then declares to himself, oh boy, today's going to be a great day for me to practice some And then...
Just like my parents used to do every day.
Yeah. As he's stretching, luckily the blanket's just covering his penis. It just stayed on there for a little bit. It's just covering it.
Well, that's what I thought you meant when you said popped out of bed.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. And as it falls off, the camera just like cuts away very quickly, so you don't see anything. And we cut to David Twattenborough.
I shall be downstairs checking the mail.
Okay. I was gonna break
mail
break
what?
break character boo. We're gonna break character for a second. No one's ever just checked the mail before.
No.
This has never happened. Like, I don't know what to do. The mail is...
We win. There's a scratch card.
The mail's mostly just like old birthday cards that are late and that sort of thing. Nothing very exciting. But it's there.
Well, the sun's
got money in it though.
Yeah, it's a Sunday. What the fuck? Something's weird. Something's not right.
Somewhere Uncle Vernon's shaking furiously.
Yeah, I'm going to roll for Uncle Vernon. Hold on.
I guess he's canon now.
Yeah, he might not be for long. I rolled a 19, so let's have a look. Uncle Vernon, he rolled a 1. He fucking explodes.
R.I.P.
R.I.P. Uncle Vernon.
We hardly knew you.
I think I'm going to do my usual morning routine. I'm going to put rat poison in the cat's bowl.
Okay.
Wow.
Great. So I've been
trying to kill that cat for so long, and it just doesn't work out. Maybe.
Cool. Well, that's going to be noted. We'll come back to that in a second. We then cut to the Hamburger variant.
There is a pug sat on the bed. He wakes up. He turns and sees that he just...
he was sat but asleep.
Yeah, he was sat asleep, yes. This is canon. And he looks around and there is no gun. This is Ham. And his pro is, he doesn't have a gun. His con is, he also doesn't have a gun.
Fuck's sake.
But he does talk like Hamburger and he has very little means of self-defense.
I'm so mad. My default Hamburger is has a gun. I've got to change this now.
Sorry.
David Twattenborough is very excited about this. This is the day he's going to get that pug.
He toddles downstairs. He sees David Twattenborough doing his shenanigans and he goes, hey, buddy. Fuck you.
I'm not
a fan of this.
Glare at you.
Ooh, look at you. You're like 80. I don't know. How old are you even?
I'm quite old, yes.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean I can't snap you in half, you little shit.
It actually does, because I'm very chubby. And you need to stop picking on the cat, because he is my only friend.
I have a production crew here that will do my bidding, and I will get them to snap you.
Is that how the shows work?
The production crew just shakes their heads like, we're not getting involved, lads.
They know what the pug's about.
I don't do very much anymore, except walk around, and they do it most of it for me.
He's 96, by the way.
Hello, everyone!
Good morning, mother!
Hello,
Mom immediately pisses. That was very loud.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay.
What's happened? Well, hello! Are you
chilling?
Can I ask where the mail ended up?
I
pissed on it.
I read the cards. Who were the cards from?
I'm just pissed on them, so I'm not touching them. They're covered in dog wee.
One of them is from...
Oh, not
from
fucking
sister.
Auntie.
It says, happy birthday, but it's very late.
Well, fuck her then.
I agree. There is also possibly maybe some money inside.
No.
Oh, no, never
mind. You cheeky sod. Not today, you cunt. Hello, sweet potato.
Sweet potato goes over to the mail. As you know, cats like to sit on paper and things like that. He gives it a sniff and he's like... Smells a
sniffy perception.
Weird. 12.
I got 2, you're absolutely fine, yeah.
Ham looks very proud of himself for some reason.
Puffs his little chest out.
Yeah.
He can tell it smells weird, but because he's not got the brain cell, he's like, I'm sure it's fine. And he just sits down on top of it anyway.
You stupid fucking cat! I literally just said that. He's pissed on the mail. He's so pissed.
Ham's like gesturing towards her, like, oh, yeah, that's my piss. That.
Potato just looks at mother and goes, what? I don't get it.
Never mind. Hello, Mr. Stevenson.
Hi, good morning, Mother.
Luckily, the salt shake is covering your very small willy, so that's good. How are you?
It's a little bit cold, but it's all good.
No, it's not hot!
Quite warm, yeah, actually.
It's windy, mate. Did you listen to the beginning of the episode? It's windy as fuck.
Windy outside. No, it's very warm.
Well, whatever. You don't have any body hair on. It's always a little cold.
Oh, yes, it is, my darling. Will you marry me, Mr. Stevenson?
Oh, yeah.
Of course. Oh, I'll marry your mother.
Oh, so
you've unlocked the side quest, Marry Mother.
Woo.
You have 7 hours to marry Mother.
Mother, why wait? We have ham here. We have sweet potato. We have some old guy. We have this beautiful crew.
Sounds like the food is sorted.
Why don't we just get hitched right here in the kitchen?
I agree. It's so romantic. Who wants to be my best bride of honor? What the fuck is it?
Remember, it could be any gender.
Thank you,
Who wants to be my man's maid?
Yeah. Who wants to fucking stand next to me at the wedding, basically?
I can't stand very long, so
I can't wait for the objection part to happen.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Okay, David Twattenborough, you can sit down.
Oh, thank you.
Sweet Potato, will you be my best cat?
Yes. Sweet Potato gets up and rubs himself against
God,
Mother's legs.
Oh, God, you're sick of piss! Jesus Christ! Fuck me. Right. Ham?
Yes.
You do the honours of marrying us.
Sure.
Thank you.
Turns out I'm legally obliged to do that.
Yeah.
Obliged wasn't the word I meant, but that's more interesting.
Well, maybe his ordained letter came through in the post.
There we go.
I was forced to be ordained by a witch.
that old trope.
Yeah.
Right.
You do have to say, do you? This is Stevenson.
Oh, I said no. I do. Does that mean I'm married to her now?
Oh, oh no!
roll. Yes. Okay. So Ham accidentally marries himself to Mr. Stevenson.
Sweet. He looks proud again.
No, this is a nightmare. What happened to my wedding?
Well, it's okay, Mother. I have the bigger willy.
Oh. Are you up for a three-way marriage, Ham?
Sure. Who? Couple. Everyone loves three slices of fat. I don't know what I'm talking about.
please marry. Oh, fuck it.
Unfortunately, the quest has run out. You've lost the quest.
The quest has run out.
Yeah, it's just done.
It took 7 hours for us to argue about that.
Yes, it's broken. You can't marry Mother. The quest is not complete. But you do marry Ham, which is has happened. So there we go. Congratulations, everyone. You marry Ham.
Yeah.
You're welcome.
What a beautiful wedding.
Right, anyway, now that's over with. I've got a little task for everyone. I need you all to go to the Budgens, buy me a...
Suddenly, glass shatters.
It's so cold!
And in walks Stone Cold Steve Austin. Yeah. Yes. He walks across the table, climbs up to one end of the chair, raises his arms in the air, walks diagonally across the other side of the table, raises his arms up in the air, then walks to the other edge, and just lifts up both sides. Then he looks at Woke Hogan and stuns him.
Here we have two elite wrestlers battling it out right here.
11!
Over 5.
So you do get stunned, but you don't die.
He knows how to it's Woke Hogan.
Yeah.
Just like that time in the Silver Dome! Super Dome, brother!
That's a reference. Alright, anyway, I need you all to go to the Budgens to buy me a scratch card!
What?
I need you to go to the Budgens to buy me a scratch card!
What?
I need you to go to the Budgens to buy me a scratch card!
What?
I need you to go to the Budgens to buy me a scratch card!
Sorry, I heard you. I thought it was a game.
He's not in this
room. Hearing.
What?
Brother.
What?
What?
The game. He's not in this loop, brother.
I understand that reference. I'm a pug.
Did Woke Hogan referencing a loop,
yeah,
make him aware of other loops?
A loop of friendship.
Is he talking about a loop? He just is it, I thought he was just referencing Triple H.
Ah, very good.
You roll a 20, please, Ollie.
Oh, fuck me. Or number four.
Got six.
Triple H in a previous loop?
No, but he said you mentioned a previous. You mentioned this loop, so I'm going to count it as a previous loop. I'm being unfair, so unfortunately, Woke Hogan does just collapse.
One,
he's very old.
Two.
Unlike Shakira, my hips did lie. Unlike Shakira, though, I'm not going to jail, brother. Ham goes over and lifts his arm and drops it.
He's out. Right, you're going to get Budgens then.
I guess so. I don't have a gun.
Sure. What? Oh, fuck me. Right, get out, please. I'm stressed.
Mother, what scratch card do you want?
Good chat. Number one.
Okay. You give us money.
Easy to remember.
I can't give you anything anymore.
Oh.
Anymore?
For fuck's sake!
Well, is it anymore? Remembering a past loop. Mother dies.
Do over. I'm doing that.
Oh, you're doing over?
I'm doing
do
over. Mother's death.
Yeah.
I want to leave the house.
Okay. Emmy?
Yeah.
Ollie?
I'm dead.
You still have to
go. Oh, sorry. Yes, do over.
Cool. So Mother bangs her head on the table and just wakes up again. Oh, fuck me. Right. You're ready.
I guess.
1 second. Stone Cold goes to the fridge and with the beer.
Roll a 20, please.
That is a 5.
There is no beer, sadly.
You look sad.
Oh, sad cold Steve Austin!
Mr. Stevenson would like to go and look around the kitchen to see if there's any spare change or anything that we could use for money.
Can you roll a perception on 20, please?
I rolled a 5.
I rolled a 6. You'd find nothing, sadly.
Sweet Potato rummages around in Mother's handbag and brings out her purse to see if there's anything in there.
Can you roll a 20, please?
12.
I got a 1. You find a purse full of money.
Sweet Potato carries it in his mouth and says, and then gently puts it down and says, can someone with pockets take this, please?
Yes, absolutely. I can take that.
Don't know if I trust you.
I put my hand out and suggestively, come on. And I offer up some chin stretches.
Shit. Because Sweet Potato has no brain cell, can you roll a 20? I roll a 20 piece Sweet Potato. Not an unfair, but just a 20 to see if you do it.
A 10.
I got a 20. You absolutely go forward and just get the scritches from David Twattenborough.
And I'm gonna, starts purring.
I'm going to really, really gently keep scratching, and then I'm just going to really, really quickly pick you up and throw you.
Jesus Christ.
Suncold's got some attempt to catch the cab.
Can you roll a 20 piece, Suncold?
Fucking wildlife.
I got a 18.
Fucking wildlife about a domestic cat.
House cat.
That's the episode title right there. Fucking wildlife. Yeah. I got an 11, so you do catch the cat.
He catches it like a beer, and then he's like,
Sweet Potato is traumatized at this point.
Traumatized.
So, Costello then put Sweet Potato pissy on his shoulder.
Oh.
That's what you say. It says thank you and settles into the shoulder.
I look at the pug and I say, you're next.
That was a good movie.
Right, is everyone ready?
Did I get the purse?
Purse is on the table still.
Oh, okay. I'll grab the purse.
Right. Can you roll a first center, please? Because you're old as fuck.
You're rolling them for me?
I am, yes. I've got a 9, you got a 12, you're absolutely fine.
Woo.
You grab the purse. Right, anything else you want to do, lads? And cats and dogs?
Mr. Stevenson reaches behind him. Mm-hmm. There's a loud pop and produces a briefcase and says, well, I am all ready to go. And heads to the front door.
Mother just looks at everyone else. What the fuck was that?
Nature's pocket.
Okay. Right.
He has an impressive asshole.
I hobble afterwards.
Stone Cold just leaves.
Mother just like, she's lost.
I don't understand. Right, get out, everyone. I need to lie down.
This would be a great time to remind you of a Patreon. Patreon.com/BudgensandDragons.
everyone goes outside.
While we're outside, is there anything we can use to barricade the door?
Have a look.
I have also changed into my walking outside attire, which is old style jungle explorer hat, boots, and
gun. Boots and what?
Kind of like the hunter of Jumanji.
Did you do boots and gun?
A gun, yes.
Very cool.
What did you gun get, goes Alex? Far, fuck.
It's a more of a musket.
I got 11.
I got 10, so you find it's not like a very strong looking branch, but it's a branch anyway.
Yeah, thank God we'll pop out against the door to secure it from any intruders or whatever that may be around, because it's found in a dangerous area.
That's absolutely fine. Now, can Sweet Potato roll for 20, please? Because it's very windy and he's just sat on Snuggle's shoulder.
Okay. 10.
I got a 1, you're absolutely fine. In fact, you like grip onto his shoulder. Your brain cell kicks in a little bit. You grip onto his shoulder, so you're just like firmly on him for now.
The claws just go in a little bit into just the fabric of his top, just to hold on.
Would that not reaffirm the brain cell trigger?
Yes, yes. Fibonacci has a brain cell. So, David Twattenborough, I'm going to roll an event for you. It's a secret event, so that's fine. Mr. Stevenson, I'm going to roll for you as well. Secret event. God. Okay. That's happening. So, as you walk outside, you see a couple of the neighbours just shut their curtains very, very quickly. One woman faints.
Sweet Potato hears with his good hearing the curtains closing, and he's like, guys, what was that?
I think a old lady has been robbed or attacked.
Is she okay?
I'm quite worried. Maybe we go check.
Maybe we should check.
I'm going to go knock on the door of the fainted lady house.
Okay. No one answers. I got a 1.
Stone Cold Sylvester stuns the door to open it.
the door.
That's another 18.
I got a 1. The door just explodes.
The door sells it like The Rock.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, so you just see a woman has fainted. She had her phone in her hand. That's all you see.
This whole time, Sweet Potato has still been hanging on Stone Cold Steve Austin's shoulder, by the way.
Oh, yeah, so yeah.
During the stunner.
She got squished by a door then.
Can I check the phone to see what she was doing with it?
Yes.
Was it a mobile phone or a house phone?
Oh, it was a house phone.
Okay. I guess I'll just put it back on the receiver.
No, wait, don't put it down.
Before she got to give her first answer, he already has put it down.
Oh, can we do that thing where you dial the last number?
Yes. What's the number, Emmy?
Does anyone know that thing where you dial the last number?
1471.
Let's dial 1471. Using the brain cell, Sweet Potato nudges the receiver off and then uses his nose to dial 1471 and puts his big cat ear up against.
And then I say down the line, hello, operator.
Hello, my darling. Who's this?
Mother, is that you?
Sweet Potato, what the fuck's going on? Firstly, how are you calling me? Secondly, why are you calling me?
Well, we're just checking on one of the neighbours who fainted.
In my task, did I say go bother the fucking neighbours?
Well, no, but we worry about the neighbours, you see. We like the neighbours, so we just wanted to check if she was okay, and it was like she was just on the phone with you. Is that what made her pass out?
I'm not. What are you trying to say?
That's crying.
Well, I don't know. Did you give her any bad news or anything? I'm sorry, Mother. I love you. I'm not sure.
You made her faint, you fucking cat. You're coming here. The dog pisses on my table. Some guy walks out with a wheelie out, pulls a sick head out of his arse. Stone Cold comes in, kills Hogan, and David Ambrose throws you against the fucking wall.
In fairness, it was a great piss.
I just always go to Budgens.
I'm sorry, Mother, I'm not trying to upset you.
I told you these animals
were pain in the ass. For fuck's sake. Ham, you can.
Ham leaves. Ham's gone. He's had enough of this.
You hear the phone slam down. The mother's door burst open. Yeah.
Get out of here before you can!
Mother drags David to out by his ear. Outside.
What are you looking at me? What are you fucking saying to me before you can?
I'm saying the animals are a pain in the bloody ass.
Oh, that's fine. Well, at least. Just back of the house.
Yes, she's very wily temperament.
What the hell is that
Frederick! Falls back.
I start to try and run.
Can you all have a 20, please? Can you roll a fatal 20? Because you're fuck. you got a 4.
Oh,
19.
No.
Just like, as you turn around, you just have a heart attack and die.
He just turns to dust like an Infinity War.
So David Twattenborough has died.
So Ham had already left, so he's in the distance and he's just like, I don't mind this.
Sweet potato breathes a sigh of relief.
Mr. Stevenson is just standing in front of the door with the briefcase in front of his worry, and he just kind of sees this all happen. He shrugs, picks up the gun, and heads off after Ham.
Lovely stuff.
Before Sweet Potato leaves the house, can I search for any more clues as to why the lady might have passed out?
Do a roll of 100, please. Gonna use the ultimate brain cell.
Seventy.
Okay, so you, just by your animal instincts, you look around. You see that the woman who was had her hand on the window as she was looking outside, and you deduce that she must have either caught sight of either the gun or the penis, just fainted in shock and horror.
Oh, well, at least there's nothing more sinister going on than that, I suppose. She'll be all right. Sweet Potato kind of licks her forehead a little bit to wake her up and make sure she's okay.
Dead. I rolled a 20, she rolled a 1. The lick just killed her.
Oh, I thought you were going to go, you just licked a corpse, fuck you.
Not sure what happened, but also, there's no change in her because she's already passed out, but the lick canonically killed her.
Wow. Sweet Potato, destroyer of worlds.
Fucking murder a cat accidentally.
She's dead, so I'm just watching this. We watch her fridge fit for beer.
I was a 20, you find like several packs of beer.
Stone Cold Steve, pass it to the guy off screen so we can throw him to him whenever he needs to.
Excellent. Right. Is he having one now?
Of course.
Cool. Can you roll another 20 then, please?
12.
I've got a 1, you're fine.
Yeah. He just like pulls it down his face and just drops on kind of the floor and walks out with the cap. Puts it back on his shoulder.
Thinks about licking a little bit of beer, but because he's got the brain cell, he's like, probably wouldn't be good for me, so I won't.
That's absolutely fair. And what's Mr. Stevenson going to do? He's outside already, that's fine. Lovely stuff. So, you'll catch up with Ham. Also, just out of character again, Joe, how many of you thought Ham was a bad character? Ham's fucking great.
Ham's great.
Fuck with no gun. It's like, in any other context, we're like, well, of course no gun.
but it only really works because we know Ham, what Ham Borger is, to be fair.
That's why. I love it. It's so good. So we go outside, you start walking down the street.
Fucking hell.
You come up to a T-junction, which has a sign pointing left, sign pointing right, and on the other side of the road is an alleyway.
Ham looks at the signs very intently and goes, I can't read.
Potato looks at the signs and says, I can read because I've got the brain cell, but none of this says Budgens.
Does that mean I have no brain cells? This is quite a revelation.
Oh. I don't feel like I'm just upsetting everyone today. No, Sweet Potato feels sad.
Oh,
Hamburger. Ham does a sad fart.
Oh. Harsh potato.
Okay, Kitty. Mr. Stevenson reaches out to pet Sweet Potato.
Sweet Potato purrs.
I mean, they just insulted me, but okay, fine, I guess. I'm just gonna, okay, see how it is.
Sweet Potato reaches up and pats Ham on the head. With his paw.
Sorry, I was anticipating an unfair 20 there. After a lick killed someone.
Stockholm Swanson will offer a beer to Ham and then read the signs out loud.
So is Ham going to accept Austin's beer?
Yeah, fuck it, he likes beer, I guess.
Yeah. So the guy screen throws a beer to Stone Cold Swanson, who cracks it open and pulls it down.
Before that, can you roll to see if you catch it, Alex? I've attempted to.
17.
I've got an 18, so you catch it fine?
Yep. It's the usual guy, and he cracks it and passes it to Hamburger. Like, he pulls it in his hat, so it's like kind of puddles a bit. His hat is like, his hat sack is contained beer because it's stone cold.
Mm-hmm. Is Hamburger going to drink it? Is Ham going to drink it, sorry? Can you roll up 10 please, Ham?
is
4. I got 12 Ham dies of alcohol poisoning.
Yeah, you know, kind of saw that coming.
Can I attempt to CPR him quickly to make him undie?
Yeah, roll a 20.
I was betrayed by my only friend.
That's a 1.
I got an 18. So you push on his heart and it just pushes his eyes out of his head.
Whoops.
Oh, not the first time a hamburger variant's eyes have popped out.
No,
I mean, it's a pugger, it should happen more often.
Yeah. So Ham is just dead by this. The Slunker was going to read out the signs. They just say Oxford, Swindon, and Alleyway, but they all say two Budgens on the side as well.
Oh, I was wrong. They do say Budgens, I've just realised.
Super Tater's brain cells gone. Just popped out.
So I'm not going to spell like Costa Rose. He's just going to continue the road down towards the just turn to the direction that was downtown.
Okay. What's Mr. Stevenson going to do? Is he going to follow Austin or go a different way?
Mr. Stevenson is brave and he's going to go into the alleyway.
Okay. Can you roll over 20 then, please, first of all, crossing the road?
Roll the 19.
I got 20. So sadly, Mr. Stevenson, as he steps into the road, a car just fucking full on runs him over. Like, they see his dick as they're coming. They're like, is that his dick? And just fucking run him over. And the briefcase goes flying.
Well, as Mr. Stevenson lies in the road dying, he just kind of looks up and says, well, I tried.
I intend to catch the briefcase.
Go on, please.
15.
I got a 15, so unfortunately, because the DM always wins, the briefcase just smacks the gold in the head.
was it Rikishi?
Let's roll. If it's a positive, if it is. It was a negative, it wasn't a Rikishi. It was a Triple H disguise, yeah. So Stun Gold does a blade job on the briefcase and bleeds out and dies.
Yeah.
I think it's just Super Tail left.
Okay. Is the suitcase landed on the floor in a place where I can reach it?
In the middle of the road.
Sweet Potato looks at the briefcase and thinks, no. And then heads in the direction that Stone Cold was originally walking in.
Excellent stuff. So, as you're walking in that direction into town, you notice there is a circus tent type of toll booth. There's a sign on the circus tent that says new and improved. So it's a brand new toll booth. In the middle of the toll booth, there is a stool and a bell.
Sweet Potato runs over and jumps onto the stool because he thinks, mm-hmm. Oh, this must be someone else's seat. I better take it. Sits up, just has a look around, and spots the bell and thinks, oh, that looks like it'll make some noise. And just paws at it, makes it ring.
Lovely stuff. Can you roll a 12, please, Emmy?
7.
7. Okay. Sweet Potato gets an extra life.
Woo! Okay. Sweet Potato thinks, that made a good sound. I'm going to ring it again.
Okay, roll 12, please.
2.
The group gets a do-over.
So I can undo a death.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Who's going to be most useful to me? I think I'll undo the most recent death.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll undo Stone Cold's death.
Lovely stuff. So Stone Cold, we cut to Stone Cold's brain. And it's just him going, so the three heads.
Just... Yeah,
yeah.
And feels then, it feels like 9 months later.
Yeah. And then he just crowd pops and he just fucking walks over the street instead of nothing happening.
Sweet Potato's like,
so, Stone Cold's version stuns the bell.
Okay, can you roll on 12,
please? That is a 3.
That's a 3. Okay, so an event in the future will change for the better.
Sweet. Let's go.
Potato.
A car drives faster. Just hear
Stone Cold glares at the cat and then just lets him get on the shoulder.
Oh, am I on your shoulder again?
If you want to.
Yes. Yeah.
Cool.
The most unsafe place on Stone Cold's body is his shoulder, but sure.
Yeah. Well, it's on his non-stunning shoulder.
Okay.
Good. Yeah. Sensible.
Yeah.
So
one's bigger than the other, you can tell.
Yeah, it's a massive.
Well, that's just got like a big dent where people's heads have been crushed into it so many times.
So what are you going to do with the bat? Are you going to leave it or are you going to walk on?
Because he broke it, he stunned it, right?
Let's roll for it. The bell is... it's fucked, yeah. cool, so you walk
We've
on...
We've just seen the bell end.
They saw the bell end earlier with Mr. Stevenson.
Yeah, I guess,
yeah. Oh, game of bell ends.
You chose to listen to this, all right.
Yeah. Potential episode title, Budgens and Dragons, a game of bell ends.
Never mind Budgens and Dragons. It should have just been called a game of bell ends. Yeah. Let's be honest.
We Stone Cold and Sweet Potato are walking down the street. They're walking to the roundabout.
Did it
again? So there's two sections to cross over to get to the other side of the roundabout.
Potato clings to Stone Cold's shoulder a little bit tighter.
Okay, can then the Stone Cold roll over 20, please? And Sweet Potato roll a 20 as well.
And there's a 7.
15.
Sweet Potato claws at the Stone Cold's shoulder, which makes him bleed out again.
God damn it.
Can maybe. Was that a lethal 20 or unfair 20?
Unfair.
Can we take into consideration the thick leather that Stone Cold will be wearing over his shoulder from his jacket?
Roll a
20. 11.
So you got an 11. So unfortunately, no, it won't count in this case. Stone Cold does die.
Okay.
So yes, Stone Cold just dies again.
The guy with the beard pours one out for Stone Cold.
Actually, the wind blows the beer. Can't see a potato roll up for 20, please.
A 2.
Oh, I also got a 2. So the beer just smashes into Sweet Potato's face. He gets very drunk and dies of alcohol poisoning.
I don't even know how to argue that one.
You have an extra life.
Oh, do you have an extra life?
Yes.
That's how you argue that one.
Yes. Yeah, so one of Sweet Potato's lives is lost.
I love how this is out of character.
Mm-hmm.
I love how usually Emmy's animal characters get murked very early.
Yeah,
he's actually the lone survivor.
The kids have a great time.
This cat will not die.
Sweet Potato is continuing. Is he drunk?
Yes.
Okay, so.
Oh, well, there goes the brain cell.
So where am I? Am I on the roundabout, or do I need to cross to the roundabout?
You haven't attempted the first cross yet. You're still on the other side of the road.
Sweet Potato, everything's spinning a little bit. But he attempts to use his hearing to listen out for cars and cross when it's quiet and he can't hear any cars.
Okay, so I've got a 7, so you can hear like muffled car noises, but you're not entirely sure where they are.
Okay, I'm going to attempt to cross.
Okay, well, have a 20, please.
6.
19. So literally the first step, a car just falls over on Sweet Potato. So fortunately the Sweet Potato has finally died. You just hear a little meow.
Meow.
That's loop 89?
No, that was 90.
Was it 90? Shit,
yeah,
sorry.
Yeah, didn't it?
Loop 90 done. Round of applause, everyone. Anyone changing character?
Nope.
I will be changing, yes.
Ooh, interesting.
I think I'll change to...
Okay.
If you liked ham, the next one is going to be much worse.
Sake, Joe.
Is it lamb?
No, it's not what you think it is.
Who've we got? Rob, Joe, and Mike. Cool. So, Alex, is it changing?
Yeah. Okay. I'm trying to decide which one. I might go random, actually, just because I can't think of one.
Okay. Just Garfield again. I'm going to shoot.
That is 67. No, 76.
76. You are, previous winner of the game, Cyclops.
Yes. I thought that felt familiar.
So, Scott Summers has mutated further. He's now a pony, capable of generating concussive force-based red colour beams from his eyes, but he can activate his visor as he has hooves. So, Ollie, who are you playing as?
That's still Woke Hogan.
Still Woke Hogan, love your stuff, thank you. Emmy?
Still Sweet Potato.
Love your stuff. Rob?
I will be playing as Matt Smith, the legendary naked and afraid contestant. He is an excellent hunter. He's adaptable. He's an all-round pretty good guy, really. Great attitude. He starts off with a PSR of 9.2. Mm-hmm. But he does have a large production crew that follows him around and a narrator. And the narrator can cause him some problems sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Lovely. What's his pro?
he's an excellent hunter. He's great at building shelters. He's adaptable. He's got a lot of knowledge in the wild. And he has a PSR, which is a primitive survival rating of 9.2. Very high. One of the legends of the survival world.
I was going to ask what that meant.
It's an arbitrary number prescribed by the production crew of Naked and Afraid of the Discovery Channel.
Lovely. And his con?
Con is very much his narrator. And he's naked as well. He's in the wilderness. He's naked. Looking out for the elements.
Two characters that are naked on the truck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They need for cover art Troy McClure going, "Now what you all came to see? Hardcore nudity."
You may remember me from that.
Love it. Thank you, Rob. Joe, your variant?
We do it at the start, don't we?
Yes. That's a good shout. Thank you. Mike, you the same, sorry.
So,
love it, Mr. Stevenson. Thank you. Cool. So, head to tails.
Tails.
It's tails. Yay. Get your do-over for the lads. So it's a windy 9 today, and Mother is feeling angry. So that's good. It's a windy day in Farringdon. Mother's in the kitchen making a cup of tea. We'll cut upstairs first of all to Cyclops.
Well, as a horse, Cyclops will actually be in the garden because, can't climb stairs.
Mm-hmm, that's fair.
So she's in the garden doing a munch on some grass and feeling lost about Jean Grey.
Or Jean May.
Jean May. There we go. Hey, come on. That was great.
We then cut to Matt Smith.
So first things on the agenda would be the narrator, and the narrator would explain everything by saying something like, "Matt and his team are in Farringdon. He has a fire starter and a bow. It is windy and the temperatures can drop below freezing." And Matt will emerge naked from his boma, which is in the front garden, and he'll get out, do a big old naked stretch, and he'll go and check his traps, see if he's caught anything.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, 20, please.
Yes, I can.
Oh, you have caught a one sparrow.
Oh, brilliant. Yeah. I'll take the sparrow. I'll start plucking it and get ready to put that on the fire. If the fire's still going. If it's not, I'll keep it stoked.
Fire is burning very brightly.
Wonderful. Yeah, I'll get to cooking my sparrow for breakfast then.
Now, part of the Farringdon house lore is the garden is very easily set on fire.
Yes, it is.
As it was once done by our dad and is now in the Google map photos, the garden is on, it's burnt to fuck. That's a sheet. So can you roll it? I'm going to roll it for the house, an unfair 20.
The dry conditions create a very...
In the should I roll one as well because it's in the garden?
Yes.
I've got 15.
Okay. So the fire rolled an 11. The front garden rolled a 5. And you've got 15, so the back garden's fine, but the front garden just catches fire. So,
okay.
Rob, can you roll another 30, please?
I roll an unfair 20, see what happens. He's going to go for it. He's going to fight this.
You got a 4, I got a 9, you just burn.
Oh, no.
It does not work. So, dies.
Matt Smith has been medically tapped out, so he doesn't die, he can't die. I mean, he might be dead, but it's not good for the insurance and things. So, we could sign it off as a medical tap out.
Yeah, he's tapped out of the game. He's been airlifted away, just a burning corpse. But Matt is unfortunately out.
As Matt Smith is lifted away, the narrator says something along the lines of, "After just 30 seconds, Matt Smith has been medically tapped. His PSR drops from a 9.2 to a 7.6. And the credits roll.
Yeah.
Could you do that over?
Rob said, over. Rob said that Matt can't die, so technically we cannot do over Matt being burnt alive.
Yeah, no, he doesn't. He can't die. It's not signed off as dead. Can't happen. The show would be cancelled.
Yeah. So Rob dug his own little fucking hole, didn't you, Rob?
I try my best.
Yep, and you fucked it.
I'll try again.
We then cut to Mr. Stevenson.
Mr. Stevenson is downstairs in the kitchen washing dishes and getting prepared to make some breakfast.
That's my fucking job, you cunt!
Well, sometimes you can always use some help.
Fucking one of these fucking lawyer little prick here, which is talking to no one in particular. Fucking lawyers coming in here helping, cunt!
We then cut to the Hamburger variant.
In the middle of the living room, a gun falls to the floor on its own. This is Borger. Now, his pro... Well, I'll give you a con first. The con is he can't move himself. The pro is he operates on the Ring of Power logic from Lord of the Rings. So if he can reach someone and whisper in their ear, he basically allows them to utilize him.
Okay.
But they are in, like... I don't want to say a trance state or anything, because I want them to act as themselves, but they feel obligated to use the gun.
Great. Basically, every time they say anything, I want to roll to use a gun.
Yeah.
And they're going to be good. Okay, we then cut to...
They're coming for Borger.
Yeah.
As soon as you mention gun, funnily enough. Like, you know, that's how you get them to your house quicker.
Bloody woke culture. What are you saying about woke culture, brother?
We cut to Woke Hogan.
Yeah, so Woke Hogan, he's just woken up and he's in a bad mood, you know, and he opens the cupboard and he just looks at the endless row of yellow shirts and he's done with it. He is absolutely done with it. So he pushes all those yellow shirts to one side and he finds the black one, finally. What? And he puts that on. NWO, the new woke order, bitches. And you fans can stick it, brother. And he kicks open the door, doing the air guitar. Everything's black and white now.
Great. Can Borger roll for the gun's power?
Well, can I choose my target, at least?
Oh, of course, that makes more sense. Yeah, do that. Do you choose that now or after Super Saiyan?
Yeah, I'll roll first, and then I'll choose.
Okay.
Can I just very quickly add one thing about Hollywood Woke Hogan? If ever he has to roll against an unfair 20, if he gets an odd number, he gets his "that doesn't work for me, brother." And so he doesn't have to, if it's even if he's hit by a car or if he's shot by a gun.
That's fair.
Does nothing.
Yeah, doesn't work for me. He doesn't show up.
I rolled an 11.
Cool. So your next, whoever you choose it to be, will work 100%.
Okay. Who have we got? Who has everyone been
to? Sweet Potato to go still. So we then cut to Sweet Potato.
I have a question. Is the garden still on fire?
The front garden is, yes.
Okay. Sweet Potato runs down the stairs and is like, "Mother, mother, mother, the garden's on fire!"
Oh, for fuck's sake!
I choose Sweet Potato.
Oh, no.
Okay, so the gun, like, fucking four hammers it to Sweet Potato and he just catches it, like, immediately. The Sweet Potato now has a gun and is inclined to use the gun. Sweet Potato, can you roll a d12, please, to see if you're going
Hello,
to shoot the
friend.
Gun?
Hello, friend.
Does Sweet Potato have the brain cell?
As we've seen, you don't need one to operate a gun.
12 at first. If he doesn't, he's... Sweet Potato does have a brain cell.
Interesting. 10.
Sweet Potato will shoot the gun.
Does the gun have a water gun setting?
Absolutely not.
Okay. I was hoping I could put out the garden fire.
Border. How dare you?
When
I say they're obligated, I don't mean they have to shoot it right now. They just they feel like this is my weapon now and I'm going to use it when I need to.
I've rolled for it, they're going to shoot now. So.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
in this instance, then, yeah, fine.
Yes.
I mean, if you do put out the fire with a gun, you are fighting fire with fire.
Boo.
That's got to work.
Do I choose where to shoot or...?
Yeah. You are in control. You're not in like a trance or anything. It's just you feel like this is my gun now and I have to use it.
I shoot the table in the kitchen, just in the middle of the table.
Okay.
Ooh, that felt good.
The table somehow just like flips over, and you see written on the back of the table, on the bottom of the table, is scrawled in like a screwdriver or a knife. Mother knows everything.
Every time I shoot a bow, it's like a child dying.
What? Hang on.
A sweet potato slowly turns to look at Mother and is like, Mother, what do you know?
I know everything.
A light shines down on Mother, protecting her from past loop deaths.
I remember every single fucking loop we've played of this stupid fucking game. I remember every death. I remember every single person. Every wedding I've not had. Every wedding I almost had. Every live show. Every pain and suffering. Everything. I remember it all. And it fucking hurts. So please, buy me a fucking scratch card so I can't fucking take it anymore.
I'm a gun.
Great. Thanks, mate.
Can you...
have a pug.
Whilst you're over there remembering everything, can you give us any tips?
Yeah, buy a scratch card and don't fucking die, you cunt.
Thanks,
don't forget Mother's in a very bad mood, so she's not going to be very, very helpful.
Cyclops pokes to the window and knocks on it.
Hello, mate. Oh, hang on. Can you roll level 20, please?
That's five.
Got one with dice of front.
Yeah, was looking at.
You over Mother.
Was that an unfair 20?
Yeah.
Can the light that was protecting Mother protect her from dying of fright?
One again. Nope.
No.
Light turns.
We have a do-over.
We have a do-over.
Hear the light switch just like turn off. Do-over already used.
No, because he didn't technically die.
Oh, that's true. Yes, that's right. Yeah, so you can just do it with my mother. Yeah,
bring it back.
Because Mother comes back alive. Oh, for fuck's sake. And she notices the light's gone off as well. She's just like,
all right, everyone, how are you doing?
Oh, the light's gone off. I was gonna ask if you know everything. Do you know if we're gonna win this time?
You said this time, so it's like dies.
For fuck's sake!
Mother grabs a knife and just stabs herself in the heart.
You could have used a gun, but you used a knife.
Mother rolled a one, she survives. Like, great! I've just stabbed myself for no fucking reason! This is the worst day of my fucking life!
Mr. Stevenson heard Sweet Potato mention that there was a fire on the front lawn, so he goes over to the window, opens it up, and just starts screaming out there to put out the fire.
Okay, can you roll a better than these? Mr. Stevenson.
Watch my court, yeah?
Roll the fire.
I rolled a 15, so somehow the fire travels up your urine and just like burns you alive.
I somehow knew that was going to happen. I swear.
You it just makes like sense.
That like Amazonian piss fish thing going, but with fire. Yeah.
Back to the piss fish, Joe.
Yeah.
Somehow it just, well, the fire just shoots up and burns him alive. Mother's just like watching this stunned.
Woke Hogan just stomps into the kitchen.
Yeah. Where have you been?
It's like, for a start, why is there only one woman here? There's total lack of diversity. Gets the spray paint can and sprays over the back of the table and says, Mother knows everything, NWO. And then like, I'm going to sort this out. And he stomps outside to where the fire is and he's going to give it the finger poke of doom to stop it from blazing quite so hard.
Okay, can you roll an unfair 20, a fatal 20 for the fire? You as the attacker, first of all. You've now entered a boss battle with the fire.
10!
I've got 12. The fire is not dead. The fire is now going to try and set you alight. Can you roll a fatal 20, please?
Got a lot of body oil on him.
The team have been trying for the last 2 minutes to put the fire out, but none has left. It is causing irritation across the government.
Number 15!
I've got 10. The fire
Number
does
15.
Not kill, does not kill, does not kill you. What's Woke Hogan going to do?
Woke Hogan's gonna then try and just gonna try and leg drop the fire.
Can you roll an unfair 20, please?
Number 7.
18. So the fire is hurt but not dead. The fire's gonna.
Hang on, I'm rolling my d12. Whether or not I'm gonna sell that the fire's hurt me or not.
That's absolutely fine.
4. Ow, it is hot!
Yeah. The fire like conjures up a chair and just swings at Woke Hogan. Can you all have a 10 please, Hogan?
Number 11.
Got 4, so you just don't sell it completely, you're just like, whatever.
He's gonna poke point at the fire. And because, as well, because it's all black and white, Work Hogan is finding it very difficult to determine which bits of sort of the yellow hot bits of the fire.
Can you roll out of 10 feet on the fire?
Number 10.
16. Fire is like a bit stunned, but shakes it off and just starts hitting Hogan in the face.
And rolling my D12, see if I'm selling these hits or not.
Mm-hmm.
8. Yeah, he gets hit a bit.
Okay, so the fire's like not like wrestling, but like shooting, smacking him in the face. It's like working stiff. I'm gonna roll a secret dice for Hogan. Right, if I hit, say 9 or above, other members of the NWO are gonna come in and ruin the match.
How many? Can I roll to see how many members of the NWO I have?
I rolled a 12, so Jep, roll whatever dice you want.
18. Oh yeah, I've got X Park and HBK and Sting. They're all just in. We all just beat up
Bagos here. Yeah.
18 members of the NWO, the New Work Order, run in and just ruin the match for the fire. It's not a satisfying ending. The fire just kind of runs away. It makes no sense.
Although the problem is, because we are the New Woke Order, we all look at each other and we're terrified because we realise that we're all just white men and we're having a crisis. So I think I probably need to roll an unfair 20 and see who sort of seppukus himself out of shame that we're not living up to our NWA name.
I rolled at 18, so...
So we're all dead.
Okay. Jesus Christ.
Although the no selling thing only applies to Work Hogan, and he rolled a 9. So Hogan, even with a sword, his sword just bends on his abs while everyone else dies. So Work Hogan's still in the game.
Ultimately,
just about.
Yeah.
A sword gets released from his contract.
Yeah.
Wish him well in his future endeavours.
He got fired over FedEx.
Yeah.
So mother
on his wedding
like,
day.
Yeah.
Mother's looking out of the window in this case.
All right. okay. So,
she turns around and just like,
Borger, sweet potato, are you ready to go? Something.
Yeah. What sort of card do you want?
Borger leans into sweet potato and goes, the first thing we see when we go outside, we're going to try and shoot, okay? Okay. Just there's a lot of death that just happened and none of it was related to guns.
Number 12, please.
Number 12. Thanks, Mother.
Fuck, Mother has a little cry in the corner. She just sobs.
She has had a morning.
Oh, so, you see, Potato's going to leave with Borger.
Yeah.
Now, also, the first thing you see outside is Work Hogan.
Sweet Potato shoots.
Can you roll a over 20, please?
5.
A 1.
Oh no!
But, hang on, I'm rolling my D12. See if.
I don't think that's a 12. No, you're about to roll the wrong dice as well.
It is a 12. Work Hogan gets shot.
Yeah, it's a.
Yes!
Sorry, that was Borger, not me.
a critical fail and then like a critical like win, but for the wrong reason. So not only do you shoot him, like. Sleeper Tetra shoots him once and then Borger keeps on firing. The scene in Robocop looks like it gets shot like a million times. And Work Hogan is just a fucking bloody mess on the floor.
I do not have a pug.
Sweet Potato looks at Borger and says, you're quite powerful.
Yes, I am a god, if you had noticed.
Sweet Potato turns Super Saiyan. So glows yellow, just like big hair.
Okay.
Nothing else has changed, just aesthetic.
Just before I die, my last words are, I'll be on Impact next week.
So what's Sweet Potato and Borg are going to do?
Are the only ones left?
Yep.
Just going to start walking down the road towards Budgens.
Say we shoot things.
What do you want to shoot?
Things.
Okay, I'm going to roll. If it's an even number, it'll be a house. An odd number, it'll be a person. Okay. It was a 7. You shoot the first house you see. The house collapses, kills everyone.
Borger looks at Sweet Potato. Just to clarify, this is not a sexual thing for me.
I wasn't thinking that until you said it. Now I'm a bit suspicious, to be honest with you.
Yeah, well, deal with it. I have a gun.
Okay.
I'm going to roll for the brain cell. That was an 8. See if it has a brain cell.
Oh my God, you are a gun.
You are astute.
Thank you.
I like this cat.
Should we go to Budgens?
Sure, we can shoot
if
a Budgens.
These guys
if
win.
If
these guys fucking win. Supertato and Borger come across a T junction. There is a sign pointing left and right, and an alleyway on the other side of the road.
Fuck you.
Oh, an ambulance need help. Whatever.
Or maybe it's the fire engine coming to the house.
Yeah.
Maybe it's an ambulance picking up all 18 corpses in the NWO.
Anyway, T junction. What do you want to do?
Due to the combination of the brain cell and the gun, Supertato feels very safe, so chooses the alleyway.
Okay, can you roll over 20, please? Both of you across the road.
20.
13.
I got 19. So Supertato like darts across the road, but drops the gun in the process, and a car does run over the grave.
Remember me how I lived. As a gun, you shot people.
Is it possible for the gun to be put back together, or is it just...
If Supertato rolls for another brain cell, it's possible. It's gonna roll another
whoa now.
Two brain cells.
As a 15, Supertato loses the previous brain cell. So
okay, Supertato turns away from the gun and just starts walking down the alleyway. Forgets about the gun completely.
Hang on, is Sweet Potato still Super Saiyan Potato?
Yeah.
So you're floating.
Well, I thought it was just aesthetic.
Oh.
Yeah.
Fine.
So in the alleyway, you come across. Yeah! God. Motherfucker! Sweet Potato!
How do you know my name?
Fuck! Fred the Spy is going to the party.
Sweet Potato carries on down the alleyway.
His last words will definitely be fuck!
Yeah. Sweet Potato comes to the alleyway. You're in a fairly run down estate. But on the other side of the road, you do notice there is a shop. And the shop is facing away from you. Obviously, you can't quite see what it is just yet, but it is there.
It's on the other side of the road, is it?
Yeah, so you've basically got to walk down the road. It's on the
other. So don't have to cross the road?
No.
Oh, okay, yeah, I walk down to the shop.
Lovely. So you come to the shop. So for not too bad a window, people are in the shop and they're just doing the normal shopping. Do you want to go inside or do you want to look elsewhere?
I'm assuming, because I don't have the brain, so I can't read the sign to see what shop it is.
You can do a perception try, but it'd be a very hard one to reach, basically.
Nine.
You notice it is a shop.
Okay. Luke goes into the shop to ask what shop it is.
Okay. What a weird thing to do. What shop is this? As I see Mateo walks into the shop, the automatic doors open, people are shopping around just happily, not caring as a cat just walked in. and asks what shop it is. Now Arthur Morgan behind the desk just goes, my God, it's a cat. Well, you're in cast cutters, boy.
Oh. First of all, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Love your hat.
Thank you. I love your fur.
Thank you. I clean it every day.
I'm just going to roll Arthur Morgan. He's now a furry.
My boy.
Extreme noses pounces on you. Ooh, you're so warm. Couldn't help but notice your bulge from across the floor. Noses, you're Nicky, wakey, till day, or till day.
Easy, boy.
Sweet Potato backs away ever so slightly and says, I'm really sorry. This isn't the shop I meant to come to. I'm not feeling very clever today. Could you tell me how to get to Budgens?
I could tell you. I once fucked a dog.
That's not what I asked, though, is it?
I pleasured a horse once. He's a boy.
Do you know how to get the Budgens?
Let me roll my intelligence.
Eddie, I feel like you've got a very wrong idea of what a furry is.
I do, yes. I rolled a 1. I don't know shit. I live in here. I was born in here. I'll die in here. I don't even know what a furry is, for fuck's sake.
Or what Arthur Morgan is.
Yeah. How dare you.
Okay.
Do you want some bread? Dead Redemption? 2.
Oh, God. Some bread.
Yeah, I'll have some bread. Sure.
Go on. Okay, the bread will be 8 pounds.
I'm a cat and I don't have any money.
Well, then you get the fuck out of my shop.
Okay, bye.
Goodbye.
Oh, leave the shop.
That was pleasant, mostly.
I was able to leave the shop having accomplished nothing. what do you want to do?
Carry on. What do I do? I look around to see if there's anyone outside the shop.
Cool. So you notice some people are standing just by where people will park their cars normally. So you see. It's going to be helpful. Meep, meep.
Hello.
Meep.
He's here, he rubs his head to say hello.
Meep, meep.
Can't tell me where Budgens is, can you?
Meep.
Oh, okay, that's great. Thank you.
Meep.
And sweet potato heads in that direction.
Now, because Roadrunner is a bird, sweet potato's animal instincts do kick in. So as he walks away a little bit, turns around, like slinks into the grass, does a little butt shake. Can you roll an unpretentive as a Roadrunner?
A 12.
I've got a 1. You fucking leap. Sweet potato leaps up and just like kills Roadrunner. You just like a row! Everyone's just fucking dead in a pile of feathers.
There is a coyote standing on a cliff looking gobsmacked right here.
Yeah. I was going to say, it cuts the coyote just looking absolutely fucking like...
Yeah, just like stomp.
Wait, I've got... Just do that.
Yeah. Well, Loki is always trying to target Roadrunner, my Lego figures that I made.
It's true.
Cats.
The sweet potato starts eating his prey.
Oh, great. Can you roll up the please?
Fun fact, in real life, Coyote would absolutely murder Roadrunners every single time.
Yeah, I
said
that.
I'm a 7.
Okay, I'm sick 11. Of this anti-coyote propaganda.
I rolled an 11, so as you eat Roadrunner, you didn't realise that he was already filled with some Acme TNT, and Super Tech just blows up.
Coyote gets his damn revenge.
Yeah. As Roadrunner blows up, and then just like... And that is all, folks.
Second Looney Tunes fake out of me.
Can we take into consideration the thick leather that Stone Cold will be wearing over his shoulder from his jacket?
Roll
a 20. Does he?
Yeah, his leather jacket's...
11.
Jacket. Am I the only one who's picturing going around in his trunks this whole time? Don't know what that says about you.